Let's imagine for a second that we've got the problem of predicting the probability of heads for some coin flips where maybe the coin is slightly bent. You might use features like angle of bend, coin mass, all kinds of stuff in there. What's the simplest model you could think of using? Well, we could maybe use linear regression like we've used before. But there might be some weird things there. For example, what if we have a new coin that we're predicting on that has a very heavy mass we've never seen before? Or what if we have an extremely large bend of the angle? We might end up with predictions that are outside the range 0 to 1. That would be really weird for probabilities, because probabilities are a special thing. Probabilities are bounded between 0 and 1. And if we have a prediction model that gives us a value outside that range, we're going to be in trouble, especially if we say try and multiply predicted probabilities or use them to create expected values and stuff like that. Well, as a first hack, you could try and cap that prediction to ignore any outlier values. But now we've introduced bias into our model, and we're not going to be very good there. So really, the right thing to do is to come up with a slightly different loss function and prediction method that allows our values to be interpreted naturally as 0 to 1 probabilities and never exceeds that range 0 to 1. So we call this idea logistic regression. It's a prediction method that gives us well-calibrated probabilities. And these are fantastically useful. We can use these as real probabilities and multiply them with things to get expected values, and use them also for things like classification tasks, where we really want to know the real probability that an email is spam or not spam. So let's take a look at how this might work. We take our familiar linear model and we stick it into a sigmoid. And a sigmoid is basically something that gives us a bounded value between 0 and 1. There's asymptotes, so it never quite hits 0 and it never quite hits 1. At training time, we're training using a different loss function. As we said, squared loss is not going to cut it here. We use something called log loss. That if you squint closely at the formula there, it looks very similar to Shannon's entropy measure from information theory. Now, you don't need to understand the math to be able to take a look at the graphical interpretation, where you'll notice that as you get closer and closer to one of the bars, the loss gets very, very high quite quickly. Again, we see those asymptotes coming into play. So those asymptotes are actually quite important to think about in terms of learning. Because of those asymptotes, we will need to really incorporate regularization quite explicitly into our learning. If we don't, then on a given data set, the model may try and fit our data ever more closely, trying to drive those losses near zero. So L2 regularization can be extremely helpful here to make sure that our weights don't go crazy out of bounds. Why do we like linear logistic regression? Well, one thing is that it's really fast. It's extremely efficient to train, and it's efficient to make predictions. So when we need a method that scales well to massive data, or that we need to use for extremely low latency predictions, linear logistic regression can be a great choice. If we need nonlinearities, we can get them by adding in feature cross products.